Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? The currently farthest planet in the solar system. Sorry, Pluto, I still think you're a planet, but the IAU says no. Neptune is visible in our evening sky. It reached opposition on September 10th, so we're a couple weeks past that, but at that time, it was really close to a fourth magnitude star, so close it was actually a little difficult to separate because Neptune is only about magnitude 7.8. So where can we find the eighth planet out there? Well, along the ecliptic to start. So when we look at where the ecliptic goes, pull up our markings and we could do the ecliptic of date. We can see how Jupiter is over in the southwest. Saturn is over there by Sagittarius, also in the southwest. And then we move over to the southeast, then Neptune is right there near that ecliptic line. But finding it is not necessarily all that easy because it's in the constellation of Aquarius. Aquarius is not a bright constellation. There are some brighter stars in Aquarius, but if you look at how the constellation goes, yeah, these are the two bright stars in it, and the ones over here, not so much. Even the stars over here in one of the fish heads of Pisces, not terribly bright. But we have some stars that are bright enough to help get you in that neighborhood of where you want to be able to look if you can't see the fourth magnitude star that Neptune is near, which a lot of us can't because of light pollution. So if you look at these stars of Pegasus, these are all about 13 to 15 degrees apart in the Great Square of Pegasus. So that's fairly simple to find. We can look and find the horse head over here. And Aquarius is below kind of where the head goes upside down across the sky. So if you take this star, which is right there at the neck of Pegasus, and then this one by the foot, so not where Andromeda goes out this way, but these two stars like this, and then you just keep that line going. You're going to go past this western fish head of Pisces. And if you use binoculars, you might even see this star as you kind of pass by there. And you're going to go about not quite double that length. So these stars, if you measure them very carefully, they're just about 13 degrees. So if we go another 13 degrees, yeah, we're not quite there. And then you'd have to go basically another 7 or 8 to get to where Neptune is. So 1.5 times that distance of those stars in that Great Square of Pegasus. Now that's a long way to go because most binoculars are only going to get you about 5 to 7 degrees. So we kind of have to just trust that we're going there. But I want to show you what stars are going to be visible that will make it easy to know that you're in the right spot. So I'm going to take off our measuring tool here and zoom in on this area. And look at these stars right here. There's that three stars really close together, and then this other star right there, and then that one. So if we actually take away those stars, the lines from Aquarius, you can see how this is going to look in the sky. So these three little stars are going to be very obvious. Let's center on this one for the moment and then pull up some binoculars and we'll see what we're looking at. So here's a binoculars view, which is going to be similar to what many finder scopes will also show you as well. And as you can see, there's those three stars. 1, 2, 3. They're all really close to each other. Pretty simple to find. This one. And then this is the star that we really want to be looking at, Phi Aquarii, because Neptune is not even a degree away from there. So almost any wide field telescopic view is going to show you that. So just barely past there, you can see how those three stars are. But we want to know how we get there from Pegasus. So here's what we can do. So here's our star from Pegasus that we're going to start from. We bring up the binoculars. Which direction are we going? We're going this way, right? So we're going to follow these. We're going to see these stars. So there's like, I don't know if that's a parallelogram really or what, but that's sort of a rhombus shape maybe. We keep going. There's some Pisces stars. Actually, if we pull over just a little bit, these are kind of like, that's that fish head area, I think, of Pisces. Go this direction and keep going. And again, it's just sort of trusting that we're there. Oh, there it is. And there's Phi Aquarii. So I'm going to do that again, but I'll do it so I kind of go about a 7 degrees distance each time. So here's this again. We're going to pull right in there. So we go all the way over. So Markab is all the way on the opposite side. Now we're going to take this star and keep that going all the way over. So we're not there yet, but there's that fish head. And now we keep going with that. Push those stars all the way out of the field of view, and then just a little farther, and there is Phi Aquarii. So if you keep going and find Phi Aquarii, there's those three stars right here that you're going to find. So once you've gone past Phi Aquarii to find those, now you know exactly where you're at. So these stars are, I mean, these are also fourth magnitude stars. So 4.4, 4.2, 4.95, that's actually a fifth magnitude star. And there's a fifth magnitude star. But these are comparable in brightness. So you'll know you're in that right spot. And then go over to Phi Aquarii, move just a little bit over. Boom, there's the planet. Now, how do you observe Neptune? Well, in binoculars or a finder scope, this might be difficult unless you're under really pretty dark skies and have a very steady view, because eighth magnitude, that's not easy to see. You can see it, but seeing it for sure and identifying it, I could see it averted vision from my front yard in a 70 millimeter telescope. That was actually a little more difficult than I expected it to be. I have seen it in binoculars, but I think I had a really super transparent night that made that simpler to do. So it's possible, but let's go ahead and try to use the telescope, because the more magnification you can put on it, the more opportunity you're going to have to be able to see any kind of disk, because it's not big. 2.36 arc seconds across, that's not a lot. That's very small. So let's bump up the magnification. And we're going to get a little bit more than what we need to see, or would be able to see, probably using Stellarium. But it'll help so we can get some idea. So I've really pushed this up. So this is at about 280 times magnification. I can get that fairly easily in about a 6-inch telescope that I have. And you would be able to do the same if you've got the right lenses to be able to achieve that kind of magnification. You can see how the disk is not very disk-like. It's just a little bit larger. But the thing about Neptune is that it doesn't look like a star. It's almost point-like, but it doesn't twinkle. And so therefore, and the blue doesn't look like typical blue-white stars. When you look at an O-class star, you can kind of see it's like a whitish-bluish. This is really more of a deeper blue, so it really does kind of stand out, and I would definitely encourage you to try and take a look at our furthest planet in our solar system. Now, by the way, this is not going to move all that much over the next several months, so check this out. I'm just going to keep moving out, and you can see how Neptune, right about the middle or so of November, it sort of stops over by this star, but it's still not that far away from Phi Aquarii, and then it starts to zoom back in. Now, it is going to drop in the sky, so by the time we get out to around early February or so, it's going to be pretty low and makes it difficult to see. You can see how we start to get pretty low, but Venus drops by and we'll probably wash it completely out by late January or so. Once we get past there, you can see how low it is. There's the horizon, but we can back up a little bit in time, get a little bit higher in the sky, and then it gets back in the same range where it's difficult to see right near Phi Aquarii. But it is possible to see. Eighth magnitude, we can see that in almost any telescope. Seeing it well is going to require more aperture, more magnification. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.